Hello, my friends out there in the YouTube comic book community. This is your friend 74 Screwgun with special guest star
Mimi07.
And we're here. We came here today to say one thing to you guys.
Happy New Year!
Okay, that was enough corny shit. All right. Stay tuned, because after this, we're going to show you what I've been picking up since the last haul. And there's a few things that, you know, I want to talk about. Just about a couple of books and some tags that are going around that I was tagged in. And so we'll get to that later. For now,
check out our new channel intro.
All right, guys, 2016. This will be my first video for this year. And I haven't been making videos in a couple of weeks. You know, busy with the holidays like everybody else has been, I guess, right? But I have been picking up books, of course. And so I thought I'd show you guys what I've been picking up. And so let's start with this one here. The Deadpool and Cable Split Second. This is one of the variants, and it's the one that I liked better, so I picked that one up. I haven't read it yet, so I can't comment on the story. But I do like this story, and I think this is the last issue. It's the Captain America White. So I've been reading this one, and I enjoy it. If you haven't read it, I actually, you know, it's one of those books I suggest that you do. Grab it. And we got Harley Quinn Power Girl number 6. I also think this one might be wrapping up too. Just don't quote me on that. Picked up Howard the Duck number 3. And this is the, looks like this will be the last one with the Gwenpool like backstory in it. She will be getting her own series. But speaking of Gwenpool, did any of you guys pick up this book? The Gwenpool Holiday Special? I mean, this is only one of the variant. It came out with four different covers. Let me move these out of the way. It came out with four different covers, and this is the cover that I liked. So, I actually got around to reading this. And I have to say, this is the biggest piece of shit that I've read this year. And excuse my language, but as soon as I opened it up, and I'll open it up for you. I mean, that's what you get on the first page. Damn, sorry. Is that not the ugliest She-Hulk you've ever seen? I mean, what the hell is that? And most of the story is not even about Gwenpool. It should be a She-Hulk Christmas special, actually. Which I wouldn't mind if the art wasn't drawn like this. Like, I don't know if this artist always draws his characters like this, but it's some of the ugliest. I mean, look at this. Like, seriously, I was disgusted. And I hate to get all emotional about this right now, but you know what? I really think it sucked. So, if you agree with me, if you have read it and you agree with me, let me know. If you think I'm wrong and you think that's awesome art, well, then I guess you should get some glasses. I don't know. Anyways, moving on. All New Wolverine, number 3. You know, I'll be happy to see one day when Wolverine does come back. I'm sure he will. But this is a good character, too. I don't know why they couldn't just keep her as X-23 or whatever. But anyways, I'll continue reading that one, no problem. Another series that I've been reading, and this is number 3 that came out, is Batman Europa. This is another series that I actually recommend, and if you have a chance, go out and grab it. It's only a 4-part mini-series, but, you know, it's something different, right? It's not the usual stuff. You'll enjoy it. I don't want to spoil it, but if you have a chance, read that. Let's see, what else do I got here? Oh, of course. I picked up book 2 of Dark Knight 3, The Master Race. I didn't get a high variant of this one. If you saw my other videos, you know I got some variants of number 1. And I actually picked up a few more on eBay that I'll show you in a bit. But, yeah, I'm enjoying that, you know. I'm looking forward to seeing where they're going with that. Deadpool. And this is issue number 4. And I think it may be the last issue that I buy, to be honest with you. I like Deadpool as a character. I like his look, and I like, you know, the funniness and whatever. But I just find in this new title that's all it is. It's just being wacky and whatever. And if you like that stuff, you know, all the power to you. But, as for me, I think I'm probably going to cut this one out. Oh, picked up a few of these back issues here. I don't think I had this one. It's just a variant of Iron Gwen from the Armor Wars. So, you got Iron Gwen and you got Iron Speeder... Speeder. What do they call that? Peter Porker? There we go. Alright, I'm talking to myself. Great. And I picked this one up too because I thought I didn't have it, but it's actually a double. Which, you know, whatever. Not a big deal. Let's see. this book came out this week too. Last week. Spider-Man Deadpool number 1. And this is the hip-hop variant. And if you want to know who they're paying homage to here, go watch Chisel on his channel, Inside UFO. And he loves these covers, and he knows way more about them than I do. But I did like this one, so I picked this one up. Another variant that they had that I liked even more was this one here. And I don't know if you can you see that? It's action, basically an action figure variant, spoof, whatever you want to call it. And if you get a chance to see that one, it's really cool. Anyways, I like that. Whoa. You guys know that Hardy's Little Black Book has been out, and all the variants from that have been coming out with it. At first I thought I was gonna go crazy and try and get them all, because, you know, I am a Harley fan. But I don't know, I kind of feel like I'm being taken advantage of, to be honest with you, with all these. And if you guys have heard, they're actually coming out soon with Batman, Superman, Little Black Bag comics. So I guess it'll be a regular thing, right? And, well, you know what they say. If everybody's special, nobody is really special, right? So I'm just not going to go crazy. I picked up a few more of these. I already pre-cut them. Let's see which one I got. This is the Wonder Woman. Okay, and this is the ink sketch. And that one is by Amanda Connor. This is actually paying homage to one of the Harley Quinn books where Batman's hanging upside down, or the other way around. I don't know. Don't remember exactly. So we got that one. That's Wonder Woman. I picked up a Superman. Let's see what we got here. Oh, that one is tight. Let's crap. Here I am pre-opening or pre-cutting these ones, hoping to make this quick. But give me a second, guys. All right, here we go. Oh, actually, that is a nice one. I guess that's the pencil. But that is actually, I like that one. She looks really fudged. Well, I'll just say it. She looks fucked up. I'm not sure who the artist is on this one. Will it say inside? I doubt it. That would be too easy. I remember when you'd be able to go on the second page and get all the information. Yeah. Anyways, whatever. I actually like that one. That's really cool. I'm sure the color one looks great, but I'm happy with that one too. So that's the Superman. And I picked up a JLA. So let's see which one we got in here. Oh, this is a color. Oh, very nice. Yeah, that's a good one too. I like that one. Who am I kidding? I like all the covers with Harley. That's my problem, right? So there we go. That's that. And what else did I want to show you? Before, I did pick up... I just came actually from the store. From the comic book store. And I did pick some stuff up. So I will be showing you that. But before I do that, I just want to show you. I picked up a package of comics, or a lot of comics, on Kijiji. And I don't know, I thought it was kind of funny because there was about 100 of them. They were asking $60. I offered 30. Whatever, I ended up paying 35. But what I find funny about it is, you know when someone thinks they're getting one over on you? You could see it in their face. And the reason being is, a lot of them had water damage. Like, serious water damage, rusty staples or whatever. But I did see some that, you know, and this, here, I'll just show you a few of them. And there's a few more that I thought were worth it for the $35. So, I have a copy of this already. This is a nice copy. This is the first new Yellow Jacket, and I don't know, that might actually go up in price with the new movie, or Ant-Man 2 when it does come up. You know, I'm a Wolverine fan, and I do have these, but they were in good shape, and it doesn't hurt to have another one. That's number 5. That's number 3. That's number 2, and they did have the number 1, and I actually have to check, because I did buy this off the newsstand, or comic book stand, whatever you want to call it, back in the day, and I read it, and I know mine is in good shape, but I'll have to see, because this one this one's in awesome shape too, so I'll have to see which one's actually in better shape. The only thing... I mean, the pages are white inside, lies flat, all that. Corners are nice. The only thing it has is a little... Can you see it there? It's got a little dent there that hardly breaks the color. So, I was, you know, just based on those alone, I was glad to pay the $35. And like I said, there is still quite a few more that, you know, are decent comics, right? So... As they thought they were getting one over on me, you know, whatever. But I was perfectly happy paying the $35 for that. One thing that did surprise me, though, sorry to get off topic here, is I don't know if it's because they killed them off, but this book has dropped in value. I mean, if you go on the price guide, and you know, people were asking $50-$60 easy for this like a year ago, and it seems to have gone down to about $30, so whatever. They'll be back, guys. I mean, I'm not gonna sell it to you for $30. I might not even sell it at all, because that's just the way it goes. Okay, so I did mention that I got some books on eBay, and here, let me show them to you. Why not, right? This is Dark Knight, The Master Race, and this is the 1-in-25 variant by Klaus Jensen, and I actually have a copy of this already, because the thing was, they had this, and they had another, the one I'm going to show you next, and I wasn't really bidding seriously on this one, but I noticed that there was another guy bidding on both books, and this one was coming up first, so I thought I'd bid him up a bit here, and then he wouldn't be able to, or maybe think twice about buying the next one. But I ended up winning both of them, which I'm okay with. I mean, I paid maybe $10 for this one and 25. So, and the same price I paid for the 1 in 50 variant. So, I was happy with that. Jeez, I can't remember the guy who drew this right now. Anyways. But, yeah, I didn't have the 1 in 50, so I'm glad to have that now. And the guy ships them in nice Mylar, which, you know, is always a bonus. Right? Right. I know. I was happy to grab this one too. This is the 1 in 20. This is Deadpool number 3, but it's the 1 in 20 Rob Liefeld. And it's paying homage to, I believe it's X-Force 2. Yes, as I asked that question, X-Force 2. Let me see. Right here, yes. I believe that's paying homage to this one here. So. Anyways, I thought that was really cool, and I wanted to have it, and they had a price tag of $19.99 basically on there. And what I did is, at this store here, they give you kind of like play money. Every time you buy new books, they give you, I think it's about 10% back in play money. So I used that, and basically I got this for free. Well, whatever. You know, using the play money, I got this for free. So, comes in a nice top loader. Keep it safe. So, I was happy with that too. Okay. So guys, I know I haven't been around making videos, but I have been watching your guys' videos, and you know, because I like to leave comments. That's, you know, I like to make myself known. You know what I mean? No, I like to communicate with you guys, just like I appreciate when people communicate with me, right? Boy, this video is going kind of long. But, anyways, I've been loving your videos, guys. You're doing a great job, and keep them up. You know what? Give me 1 second. I'm just going to pause this first book here. Definitely nothing special, but I don't know if you guys have ever seen this one. I'm sure some of you have. It's a premiere issue of Nightcat. And I haven't read it yet, but the cover caught my eye, right? I could see the style of the cover, and I don't know, it looked familiar to me. So I looked it up. It's by Joe Jesko. And I could tell by the way it was drawn. And so I looked at his other work, and basically he's done a lot of work on like the Conan, the magazine covers, the, you know, the fantasy books, Vampirella, you know, and stuff like that. So it just caught my eye, and I thought, it's a buck, why not, right? Now this character is another one that Stan Lee's had the idea of having a real life person kind of portray this character. So they both came out at the same time. But you know what? I'm not going to tell you a lot about this person, because I'm actually going to suggest, and I told him that I was going to do this, Punisher 88. He does a series where he talks about lame superheroes, and I'm going to suggest that he does one on Nightcat here. So we'll let him. He does a good job with that. Check out his videos if you have a chance. So he'll research this, and he'll give you the down low on how lame or not lame, whatever. But I picked that one up there, right? So sorry about the length of this video, guys. I know it's going kind of long, but you know, I've had this all pent up for a while. So there we go. So let me just show you the books that I've got picked up this week. Real quick, we got Secret Wars, number 9, finally, the end. We've got New Suicide Squad, number 16. I hope you guys have stuck around this long. I'm my true friends have stuck around. We'll see who they are. just kidding, guys. Superman, American Alien. This is a good series. If you haven't been reading it, I suggest that you check it out. It goes up to 7, apparently. So this is number 3. And if you're like me, Superman doesn't really excite me that much anymore. Or hasn't in a long time. Except for maybe the Silver Age comics. So, but this is a different. This is, you know, this is cool. This is something different. Okay, this is issue number 4 of All New Wolverine. And this is a variant with Deadpool. And apparently it's paying homage to a Batman book where Batman slaps Robin for some reason or other. I'm not sure which book that is, but, you know. If you guys know, let me know in the comments. Guardians of the Galaxy. I'm kind of actually enjoying this series, so keep going with it until I don't enjoy it. And this number 2 came out. This is 2 of 6. Batman and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Loving the art, and kind of cool, right? It's nice to see them. And one of the big books that came out this week was The Walking Dead, number 150. And I don't collect Walking Dead. I love the show, and I'm sure the books are awesome, but I never jumped on, and the way the prices are, you know, crazy. Unless I were to find them for a good price, I wouldn't go nuts with it. But I did like the fact, and you can see I picked up 2 copies of it. I like the fact that this is not only paying homage to number 1, but it's also done by the original artist who did number 1. And apparently there was a little bit of a falling out with him and Kirkman and stuff like that. So it's nice to see that they're back. And I thought it was a cool variant to get. They also had a variant that was like 1 per store. But they're, you know, asking like $300 for that. So they can keep it till it's worth nothing. So, yeah, that's my thoughts on that one. Or, you know, maybe it's not worth nothing. But I don't know how long it's going to stay at $300. So that's what I've been up to, guys, and I appreciate you watching. I hope you stayed till the end. I hope I wasn't boring you, and if I was, well, I guess you're not here, right? So let me know what you think, and I've been tagged in a couple of videos, and guys, I really want to do them. I was tagged by Wolvie Fan, and I was tagged by Biggie's Comics, so you know, I really want to get them done. I'm just not sure when I'm going to get the chance to get them done. But you guys are awesome. So, everyone go check them out if you haven't already. And, yeah, that's what I've been up to. And I bought a bunch of action figures because one of my local stores had the Boxing Day sale, 50% off. So, I couldn't help myself. I had to buy some Funko Pops and some Marvel Selects because, you know, they're getting kind of expensive, so at half price, it was awesome. And I got them at the Hooded Goblin. If you guys are around Georgetown, Ontario, go check out Andrew and Steve over at the Hooded Goblin. I don't get anything for mentioning them. I just think they're good guys. And they've been around for about a year now, and they could use the support, right? So support your local comic book stores, guys. And for now, I'm going to be out. And that's it, guys. See you later.